He was called the Little Monster. An accidental military accident changed his whole life.
Welcome to Viral Stories. Secrets, facts, and strange stories from around the world. If you find yourself amazed at what some of our fellow humans and animals can do, this is the place for you. This is a channel you're going to want to tell your friends about. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon to be notified of our new uploads. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy Viral Stories.
A man who has shown compassion for someone else's misfortune is worthy of the highest award, and especially if this man is a military man. These were the words that one of the professors of the London Clinic tells the journalists who visited him. The story I will tell you about today has spread all over the world in a few days. The name of our today's hero, who for many years modestly told no one about anything, even got on the first page of the tabloids. So what actually happened? Believe me guys, you will find this story fascinating. A man named Wayne Ingram from Portland gave his whole life to the military. And as is known, the duty of a military man is always to help people. It was with this goal in mind that Wayne went on a peacekeeping mission in Bosnia back in 2002, when he was a senior sergeant in the 9th Royal Ulanski Regiment. The task of the military and his unit was to control the streets of the city and enforce the law, but he could not even imagine how much his life would change in one ordinary day. As mentioned by the man himself, we moved around the city. There were a lot of people on the street. Children were always coming up to us, and then we gladly gave them sweets and other goodies. Suddenly, I noticed the boy who was standing all alone, and none of his peers wanted to be friends with him. It was no surprise, because when I approached him, I immediately understood what the reason was. Because of a congenital disease, the boy's eyes were 4.5 centimeters farther apart than those of ordinary people, and his nose was completely deformed. I remember I took him in my arms and asked him his name. He answered that his name was Stefan. He had such a huge, sincere, childish smile on his face and so much joy in his eyes. Because at least someone paid attention to him, he even gave me a big hug. It touched our hero's heart. That evening, Wayne could not forget the boy's face, and the next day, he decided to find him. No one knows why, perhaps because of fatherly feelings, since by that time, he was already the father of 4 children. But somehow, he felt some connection with this little stranger, and this feeling did not leave him. When he found the family of Savic and came to their house, he was shocked by what he saw. In the post-war city, living conditions were far from ideal. Wayne told us that the Savic family were kind and pleasant people. As it turned out, little Stefan was only 4 years old. The boy was born with a rare disease, which is called facial cleft. The bone in the center of the face slowly destroyed the skull and moved the eyes in different directions, so the baby saw almost nothing. His parents are common people and could not afford expensive operations to restore the baby's face. The military man was welcomed into the house, and after that, Wayne began to visit the baby and his parents from time to time, helping them whenever he could. But the peacekeeper's stay in Bosnia was coming to an end, and in November 2002, he came to say goodbye before being sent home. Wayne said he would never forget them and would do his best to change Stefan's life for the better. Perhaps someone would have left with just a promise, but not our hero. In 2003, 6 months after the last meeting, Stefan's parents received a request and an invitation to travel to London. Of course, they thought it was some kind of mistake, because they never had relatives in England. When they found out what all this meant, they could not hold back their tears. The same military man who held the baby in his arms, returning home to his native country of Britain, decided not to sit still and organized a fundraiser. In just 6 months, the British soldier collected £85,000 and brought the boy to the Children's Hospital in London in 2003. Plastic surgeon David Denevy offered his help for free, but part of the money was spent on tickets, visas, and accommodation of the family of the little patient. During the 12-hour surgery in July 2003, the doctors had to remove all of Stefan's teeth. The boy underwent a trepanation and skull reconstruction. Dr. Denevy removed the bone in the middle of Stefan's face to bring his eyes closer and made the baby a new nose. All this time, Wayne was with the boy's parents. The sergeant's wife supported her husband in everything and also helped with fundraising. After the first operation in 2003, the two families became very close friends and kept in touch. But it was only the beginning. Stefan had yet to undergo a large number of expensive operations. In May 2005, Stefan returned to Britain again to do an operation on his nose. Since then, every 2 or 3 years, a small patient came to England to undergo another course of treatment. During this time, the Ingrams invited the baby with his parents to their own family home. For all these years, they have collected 150,000 pounds, which is just under 15 million rubles. With each new visit, Stefan came to normal, and in 2016, Wayne collected the last 20,000 pounds for the next operation. Now, plastic surgery. After the last operation, with the money which even celebrities helped to collect, Stefan had a fully recovered nose. Now, Stefan is 21 years old and lives a full, happy life, plays in a local music band, goes to university, and even has a girlfriend he loves. The guy is very grateful to his savior for the fact that he once took him in his arms on the streets of the city and changed his whole life. With tears in his eyes, Stefan said that if it hadn't been for Wayne, he probably wouldn't have lived to this day. The British soldier keeps in touch with the boy and his parents every month. Families have become real friends and often visit each other. Stefan himself calls Wayne his second father, and the military man does not hide the fact that he has another son. This story once again proves the fact that miracles do happen. They happen every day right in front of us, and each of us can be involved in it, if only we want to. It just so happened that a military man saved the life of a boy he did not know, and thus he found himself a son. Guys, what do you think about what the military man did? Be sure to write your opinion in the comments. That's all. Like the video if you enjoyed it, and see you soon.